Who's that? Who's that?
Samantha Saquella is a 30-year-old real estate worker in Reno, Nevada. She is a homosexual woman living with her wife, Morgan, and their young daughter, Quinn. After living in Nevada most of her life, she has lived comfortably and unconfined.
It's been pretty good. I haven't really had any issues with it. I'm pretty open and free in the Nevadans. Not a lot of hate. I feel very myself.
Statistics show that 26% of LGBT youth say their biggest problems are not feeling accepted by their families, trouble at school slash bullying, and a fear to be out slash open. While some communities make it difficult to be accepted, Sam has a different uprising.
So with friends, not so much. Nothing's really affected. I think because we've all grown up with it in our era, but family, on my dad's side, it really affected it. They are super Italian Catholics and don't really understand it.
No one really talks about it, or at least I didn't when I was a kid with my parents or anything. It still was kind of one of those things that wasn't commonly talked about.
Don't really know how to handle it or react, even though I'm the same person. We kind of fell off a little bit because of that.
Even though Sam never experienced being bullied, there were some societal normalcies that she had to follow.
There were times when I felt I needed to act a certain way or a type of way that wasn't who I was, just to conform to what society, you know, perceives a heterosexual couple. But I grew up and grew out of it. Don't really care what people think, so it did take a while.
With legalization of gay marriage in 2014, Sam and Morgan decided to get married and several years later have their first child, Quinn. However, Sam would have to adopt Quinn in order to recognize her as the mother. While Nevada law recognizes gestational surrogacy, the lesbian spouse of the mother must adopt the child to be considered the mother of that child.
That's ridiculous. There's so many, it's like a weird loophole that doesn't even exist. I'm on her birth certificate. I was there. I'm married. I have my marriage certificate. We're all legitimate.
I think it's kind of silly because she's on the birth certificate. She's there. It was our decision to go to the doctor to get inseminated with her in the first place. So I feel like if all that paperwork's in order, then Once she's out and we fill out the birth certificate, if her name's on it, she'll just kind of be like every other couple.
So say if I went out of country and something were to happen to Morgan and I was with Quinn, all three of us were out together, I wouldn't have rights over her. So she would go into the system.
Wow. I think that they need the paperwork to make it all okay, but I don't know if I ever will change it.
Well, I thought we had it pretty solidified. We have a marriage. We're married by law, by our state in Nevada. Have that, then I sign on her birth certificate that I am the other parent, so I'm on there. So those two documents, I think, put those together, and that should suffice enough to parent, you know, without having to go through another whole process of adoption.
The LGBTQ community have increasingly achieved their goals for rights of marriage to owning a child, but society has only seen these changes in the last few decades. Hopefully soon, more changes will come to make these processes easier for the later generations.